Good morning, friends. Happy Tuesday, May 12th. Welcome to a gorgeous sunny day, at least here in upstate New York. It's beautiful. I'm so excited, and I have to spend the whole day indoors. I am heading to our classroom today to close it up, which makes me super sad, but I got thinking about something really important that I wanted to share with you. I was there the other day, and all of our stuff has been piled in the middle of the room on the rug. Even our cool teepee was taken down and it was in the pile. And at first I got like really sad about it. I was like, hey, that's our teepee. Those are our pillows on the floor. Those are our bean bags. Like, what did you do to our classroom? And then I got thinking about it, and it was very quiet because no one was there. And I got thinking that actually the stuff in the classroom is just stuff. What makes our classroom really, really special is you. So it doesn't really matter what happens with the stuff right now that's there, because it's just stuff. And it doesn't become like breathing, living, awesome things unless you're there. Like the teepee is just a teepee until there's kids to go inside of it and use it and appreciate it. And like the pillows on the floor, they're just pillows unless there's kids laying on them and fighting over them. And you know, the stuff is just stuff. So that's going to help me today, because I have to pick a lot of things up and throw a lot of things out and change our classroom a little bit to make it safe for when we can finally go back. So that's what I'm doing all day today. So I will not be at our morning meeting at 10:30. I will positively, unless something crazy happens, be there tomorrow, because I miss your faces so much. Okay, so real quick, because I do have to get going, I wanted to first answer our question from the other day. So the question from the other day was, how far away is the moon? And one of you wanted to know that back in September. So if you looked it up or you found it online, awesome for you. You're a great researcher. The answer is the moon is 238,900 miles away, which is a really long way. And that's pretty cool. But it's pretty cool that we can see the moon, I think. I love the moon. I think it's really magical. Okay, so I have a question on our little poster that says, why do rainbows come after it rains? And Carly actually put her name on that one. So that one is Carly's. And I'm sure you all kind of wonder about that. And there is a hint, hint, hint. There is a Mystery Dug about this. So if you want to look on Mystery Dug, you can. You can look on the database and try to do some research of your own. And that would be super cool. So we'll try to answer that one tomorrow if you can find that out. That's a fun thing to try to research today if you have a little bit of time. Okay, so real quick, because I do have to go. Yesterday, I was talking to the Ditzel family. And if you guys know Miles and Olive and Lila, they are just awesome human beings. And I love all of them so much. And I have taught Miles and Olivia, or Olive, but I didn't get to teach Lila, which is a bummer. But she's in good hands. She's in Mississauga, so she's in great hands. But we were talking yesterday on Skype, and we were laughing so hard. And I was telling them about the morning meetings, and they said that they're watching them too. And Olive started laughing and she said, you need to tell them about Mr. Clean. And I was like, oh my gosh, Olive, brilliant, because I feel like I'm running out of ideas a lot. So anyway, this is super embarrassing, but also really funny. And Lila had no idea who Mr. Clean is. So to make this story even better, if you don't know who Mr. Clean is, you really ought to just pause this and go look him up. Okay, just type in Google, Mr. Clean. Get a good picture of this in your head, friends, so you know what we're talking about. Okay. So when I was little, just like every kid in the world, my mother used to drag me grocery shopping with her. And I actually loved to go grocery shopping. I loved it because we didn't have a lot of money. So when we were going grocery shopping, it was super fun. And I was excited that we're getting a lot of food and stuff. So, but here's the problem. I didn't have television. Not a big problem, except that I had a problem, even when I got a little bit older, I had a tough time figuring out like what was real and what was not real, because I hadn't really been around TV very much. So when I watched it, I was kind of, first of all, crazy and didn't want to stop watching it. It was like such an addiction. I loved it. But also, it felt really real to me because I hadn't grown up with it. So it felt real to me. So one of my favorite things on television at the time was I was obsessed with the Mr. Clean commercial. So Mr. Clean used to be just a floor cleaner, and the commercial had the woman, she poured some of the floor cleaner on her shiny kitchen floor and it got even shinier, which is awesome. You know, that's great if you're like a grown up, who cares if you're a kid. But what I loved was what would happen in the commercial was Mr. Clean would like show up on the kitchen floor and start talking to the lady about her good floor cleaning choices. And hello, he was cool. He was cool. He kind of looked like that guy in Annie, like Daddy Warbucks, a little bit. But also he kind of looked like a pirate because he had this cool earring. Now, friends, this is back in the 70s when nobody had an earring. Like, nobody. Barely the girls had earrings, much less a boy. So I thought he looked like this gorgeous pirate that like showed up like magic on your kitchen floor if you poured the floor cleaner on your floor. So I was like, I fell in love with him, and I'm not joking. Like, I was in love with him. Like, I wanted nothing more than for Mr. Clean to show up on my kitchen floor and be my friend and talk to me. I guess I must have been kind of lonely. I don't know. The point is, I was obsessed. So when my mom took me grocery shopping, like the next time she took me, I completely snuck Mr. Clean cleaner into our cart because I desperately wanted to take him home and release him from that bottle so he could be my friend. Hello, crazy. It didn't work, obviously. When we got up to the register, my mother totally was like, I didn't put this in the cart. And I was like, I don't know who put it in the cart. It was totally me because I really wanted Mr. Clean to come to my house. I thought he was so cute. So embarrassing. So anyway, today when you're writing, if you have any really weird stories like that, like, I mean, how could I fall in love with like a pirate bald guy from a floor cleaner? I was like five. I mean, come on. I don't even know. So anyway, if you have any really crazy stories like that, like yesterday, I did hear a couple of secrets from friends about people that that they have a crush on. And I love that you trust me with that because I hate it when grownups think that kids don't have feelings like that. And it's totally okay to feel stuff for people and love people. And it's not okay to have a boyfriend or a girlfriend when you're little because you're just like learning how to be yourself. But of course you like other people and of course you have feelings and that's totally okay. So anyway, it's totally all right if you want to write about that to me, and it'll be our secret, even though the whole wide world now knows that I fell in love with Mr. Clean. How embarrassing, but I will keep your secret. So anyway, I love you muchos, muchos. Have an awesome Tuesday. I'm really hoping I can get outside, before the sun goes away. I hope it doesn't go away today. Just stay, right? All right. Have a great Tuesday, friends, and I'll see you back tomorrow. Love you.